Hi! Did you know that some glass contain uranium? Some people might wish to avoid this radioactive glass, but I collect it. Makes me wonder if it is possible to spot radioactive glass without a sensitive Geiger counter. Can you find it in other ways? Would be handy when discreetly looking for it in a shop, or trying to avoid its radioactivity altogether. With some experience, you might have spotted the radioactive glass here already. But are you sure? Always respect radioactivity and take precautions. Also limit your exposure to intense ultraviolet light. Why use uranium in glassware? Well, the different ions of uranium are often visually spectacular, with different saturated colors. So uranium oxides were used as a colorant back when uranium was new and exciting, and not used for anything else. Early transparent uranium glass was yellow and quite hot, but sadly I don't have any of that. Instead, I have a lot of the later green, almost yellow-green type. These do have a noticeable color. The color is one of the first things I look for when searching for uranium glass in a thrift store. But can you tell the color of radioactive uranium glass apart from plain green glass? Let me test you. Here are three greenish glasswares. How many of them do you think are radioactive? As a little help, I will compare them with a confirmed piece of uranium glass. First item is a small, vaguely colored perfume bottle. Looks old and worn. Second item is a small bowl with a brighter green color. Also looks old and worn. Third item is a mug. Has a bright, saturated green color and is marked 1910 to 1935. Are all, some, or none radioactive? This mug is brightly green, and 1935 is a fitting year for uranium glass. But it is not radioactive. The brightly green bowl isn't either. The pale perfume bottle is radioactive. Maybe color and vintage looks are not enough to spot uranium glass from. A much better indicator is fluorescence. The uranyl ions in uranium glass are known for fluorescing green when hit by ultraviolet light. This tiny UVA light easily reveals which of these contain uranium ions. Great! So you don't need a Geiger counter, just the UVA light? Not all green fluorescence comes from uranium. This fluoresces green, but it is not uranium glass. In fact, this drinking glass is not even glass. It is made of plastic and likely fluoresces due to non-radioactive fluorescein. Uranium glassware is always made of glass. Now, you already know how to tell glass from plastic, but in two scientific terms, it is density and elastic modulus. Glass weighs more than plastic and is stiffer, giving it a clinking sound when struck. Okay, these are both made of glass and fluoresce. Are they uranium glass then? Disappointingly, no. To my knowledge, Coca-Cola has never made bottles or drinking glasses that contain uranium. Alright, after a short message, I will check these two glasses for radiation and show the spectrum of the fluorescence from a uranium glass. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. I appreciate your help with keeping these videos like this one coming. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link in the description. Thank you. Okay, let's test these two small glasses for uranium. First off, they are both made of glass. Color-wise, the one on the left looks the most radioactive green. The other one has a green color that is too dark with no yellow tint at all. On the UV light, the left one has strong green fluorescence. But the dark green one on the right actually fluoresces a bit green too. Interesting. Are any of them uranium glass? This one sure is radioactive, made of uranium glass. The other one is... radioactive too. I must admit, this one fooled me. I did not expect a glass in this dull dark green color would be uranium glass. I let my patrons have a guess, and by color alone, most of you also thought only the bright green one is radioactive. Though some of you had a hunch of both being radioactive. These glasses really show how difficult it is to spot radioactive glass by color alone. Fluorescence on the UV is a stronger indication, but in reality, you do need a sensitive Geiger counter to verify radioactive uranium glass. With that said, there is one final thing I would like to test regarding color. What is the spectrum of light from uranium glass? I will use this stem dish since it has a nicely saturated yellow-green color. The light source is a 60 watts good old incandescent bulb with a wide spectrum from UVA to near infrared, covering all of the visible spectral colors. Now I will place the dish between the light bulb and probe, letting the dish act as an optical filter. Okay, it absorbs a lot of light, but lets green and yellow pass through with a peak very close to our eye's peak sensitivity. No wonder uranium glass usually has a vibrant yellow-green color. But what about the spectrum of the fluorescence on the UV light? Starting with a 395 nanometers LED light. Nice! The fluorescence is more green than we saw from the transmitted light. The fluorescence peaks at around 531 nanometers and apparently has extra bumps around 515 and 555 nanometers or so. Is the fluorescence different when activated by a 370 nanometers light? Not really. Looks very similar to me. The extra peak at 515 nanometers may appear more distinct, but corrected for the different activation strengths of the UV lights, the spectrums are exactly the same. The spectrum of fluorescence does not change with the spectrum of the activation light. The activation light just has to be in the absorption, more precisely excitation range of the fluorophore. I have a video on the topic. I try capturing the spectrum from the non-uranium star. Not easy, since it has much weaker fluorescence. But it clearly does not have the same peak and spectrum profile. Maybe a spectrometer can be used to detect uranium glass by its fluorescence. I will have to measure more samples before I can call it. Let me know in the comments if you are interested in a video about it. Hope you enjoyed this video enough to click like and perhaps subscribe for more like it. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.